Okay. Good morning. Good afternoon. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm just going to start with a real quick video. Some of you don't know who I am, or some of you are familiar faces, old friends, somebody I consider family and loved ones. And so those of you that are new today, here's just a little bit about what we do and what we're up to. So let me make sure I am. Yep. Perfect. Here we go.
And then Shannon, thank you so much for the amazing press support, helping me put together something so unique and creative. And I think we were, full page in like 586 different publications, hundreds of millions of impressions, which led to a lot of great conversations and opening the door. So I just want to thank you and appreciate the three of you for the support and something that I've been looking forward to for a long time and making a dream reality. So
I mean, Dr. Giovitale.
He brings the wow factor into helping people connect and just showcase all the beautiful things that you of this community, because Media Magic is a community of people that are just amazing. And we have been a part of it for, 5 years now. And we look forward to it every year. And especially now that we have had things that have intervened in our live sessions, right? Because I don't even want to say the word, right? So it's so much fun. And I know that when you bring yourself into this type of environment, it not only makes you feel good and you meet some of the best people in the entire world, but it elevates your business into just a flow of success. I know it's helped our business, our friendships. I mean, we've had so many people that we've met, even from the people that are here today, that have just injected themselves into our hearts. And so we welcome you guys to join us.
Thank you. Okay, so those of you that are not familiar with Media Magic, you got to go download your copy for free.
Joy Grace, I know I'm putting you on the spot, but you worked for Media Magic.
I'm going to go ahead and pause this and get right into
this. The story that happened from what you learned, can you just share real quickly about that?
We have lots of incredible testimonials. We've been doing this for quite some time. But if you have not been able to download the book Media Magic, this is actually a workbook. And if you go to mediamagicbook.com, you can download the templates, you can download the samples. We invite you to really, get started today on what we have. We have all of the key components of a power bio and press release and great samples. And so if you go to mediamagicbook.com, that would be a great place to get started. So we are here today to master your pitch. And let me make sure this is off. Okay. Here we go. And so we're going to be talking about the five steps to creating that elevator pitch. And actually, I'm going to be sharing a little bit more. I've got seven essentials. We have this concept of over deliver. So we love to be able to do that. And my intention today is to really help you grow, help you accelerate your business, have some fun. We love having lots of laughs. We love celebrating everybody, and my goal is to help you do all of this while making money too. And so those of you that may not know about the Business Acceleration Network, we are a trailblazing community of conscious business owners. We're here to make an impact. We are reinventing community and collaboration in entrepreneurship. We have a number of our collaborators here. I wanted to say hi to Amanda. I also wanted to say hi to David Dunworth, Diane. These are individuals that are a part of our community. And Yang, if you can share our link to our community, that would be awesome. And I see a bunch of you that are here to listen. listen, it's okay if you are just here to audit. I do want to let you know that we have an agenda today that we're hoping that you will engage in. And when I say engage in, we are going to give you the opportunity to be able to network with individuals that are here, be able to share your pitch if you choose. We do that at the end because sometimes people are a little bit shy and they, you know, they don't want to share. But if you're here for Media Magic, I want you to know that my screen is sharing a black stripe covering some of the content. Let me see what's going on here. You want to know why? Thank you. Because I have all of you guys. It's tying in on my Zoom stuff. Just a minute here. That's it. Let me get this up here. Stop sharing. Let me make sure I have the right view, speaker. All right, I think we've got it. Thank you, Diane, for letting me know that because we want to make sure that you are able to see everything. Let's try this one more time. And is that any better? It's still, I don't know why it's still showing that black dot. That little black dot is the speaker.
It's much better though. It's not all the way down. So.
Okay, perfect.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. So our agenda today is, I'm just going to quickly touch on the six business accelerators. Do I have everybody's permission to be perfectly imperfect? That's one thing that
oh, yes,
I love Amanda. She's got the hands up. It's like, you know, when we do these events, I love what Dale Carnegie says. He says, we really are giving three speeches. It's the, we plan to do a speech, we do a speech, and then it's a speech that we wish that we did. And so, you know, that's often what happens. So thank you for allowing me to be perfectly imperfect. Hopefully this inspires you to know that you can go out there and get millions of dollars in media and still fumble and bumble and be magnetic. And so I'm going to quickly talk about the six business accelerators for any economy. This is really what we do at the Business Acceleration Network to create that magic. And with everything that's going on in the world, we've got to come together as community. We've got to really collaborate. We've got to play together unlike we've ever done before. And that's what we stand for. What is media magic? We're going to review what that means and how to play with that. We're going to learn some of the tools for creating an elevator pitch that really stands out. And then we're going to give you the opportunity to network with those individuals that are here. And I'm telling you right now, I'm looking at the list of people that are here and there are some pretty powerful people here. And so I hope that you stick around for that part. This is the opportunity where we'll get into breakout rooms and you'll be able to practice what you learned today and get that direct feedback. And the best part is we actually have people that email us afterwards and they say, oh my gosh, I got a lead. Oh my goodness, I met my new best friend. Or, oh my goodness, I get to go to Florida and hang out with Shannon. I mean, you never know what happens in these collaboration rooms. And so that's why, you know, when you show up and you get to connect, that's powerful. And I'm going to invite you to please get on your camera. It's not required. You can audit this. But I do know that when we get into the interactive space, this is streamed all over the place. And we'd love to be able to showcase you. And we'd love, you know, people connect with people that they know and connect with. And then we're going to talk a little bit more about how to, what's next. So the six core business accelerators, those of you that don't know me, you know, I built a large international company. And after a number of years, I had not only a health challenge, but an economic shift. And I ended up at ground zero. And I have to tell you, when I got to that ground zero, I really had to look at what are the key things that helped me start the business. Because at the time when I started, I was a single mom struggling, didn't have a market budget, but I had a passion. Like I was like, oh my God, the world needs this business so bad. What do I do? And so these six core business accelerators are things that I've used over and over again. These are things that part of why we love the Business Acceleration Network is that we're constantly finding ways to integrate these into all that we do, all of our events, because it's that magic. Whether you pick one or you pick all six, these are things that'll help you grow. And the first thing is master your elevator pitch. Lisa Nichols with The Secret says it the best. The one thing that's stopping us from getting what we want right now is our language. It's how we communicate. I've been able to sit with people and just tweak a couple of things that they're saying. And all of a sudden they went from, you know, trickling clients or no clients to turning on a faucet. And that's what we're here today to do. Also collaborate and joint venture. And that is essential. We've been taught, we've been ingrained. We've been, you know, we're in this place where it's competitive. And I have to tell you that part of what we do is we help people that are even in the same business find ways to collaborate and find ways to see how that power of coming together can really help you grow. Build your team, mentors, and coaches. If you are alone, the only thing that is in the way of you is asking, showing up to something like this. We have so many mentors in our community, mentors of people that brain tie, that come to give, come to serve, come to help. Have your team. I have Yong here on my team. I have an incredible team. You know, we all should have teams, coaches, and mentors. If you are alone, then, you know, really take number three and look at, okay, how do I build my team? Even if it's an advisory team, people that work for free that might give you feedback once in a while. And then treat everyone as if they're significant. Treat everyone that you meet like, you know, I don't know about you, but there's a great book called The Millionaire Next Door, and they talk about how often, you know, we there are millionaires around us, but we don't know because they may be driving a Honda Civic. They may be wearing, you know, holy blue jeans. It's like if we treat everybody that we connect with as if they are the most important person, that next step in our business, you would be amazed at the miracles that happen. And so we also have this concept of give first. It's like, if there's something that you give, if there's something that you share, you know, do that. And in your elevator pitch, I always tell people, if you have an opt-in or you have something that you give away, let people know. Many of you guys do free consults, but you don't share that in your elevator pitch. So if there's something where people can get to know you, make sure that you include that in your pitch. And mastermind your goals and challenges. I mean, this has been around as old as time. I mean, I often kid around. I say, I think the Last Supper, they were really coming around and masterminding. Okay, here's our goal, you know, and there is no problem in the world that we've ever been able to connect with it without getting brilliant minds together with that shared vision of connecting and collaborating. And that's what we do at the Business Acceleration Network. We just got a message from Amanda this morning in our group chat. And Amanda's like, hey, I have all these great products. I'm trying to set up affiliates. What do I do next? And wasn't it great, Amanda, within a short period of time, you're able to get that instant feedback. And that's what happens. That's really what we stand for with accelerating our goals. And then the next thing is creating media magic. So what is media magic? Media magic is simple. Media magic is you don't have to be a copywriter. You don't have to be an expert. It's finding and telling a story that gets people to say, I want to know more. And each and every one of you, if you're on here today, I guarantee, I love this challenge. I'm like, please challenge me, because there is not one person I haven't been able to sit with where I couldn't come up with at least 40 to 50 stories or articles. And when I say stories or articles, you know, I think we have a lot of constantly negative news. Anybody else want to give me anybody else agree we have a lot of negative news in the world right now? So when I think of media magic, I think about how do we uplift? How do we connect? How do we, you know, we will talk about problems. We will share the problems, but we really are here to elevate. And so we love to focus on things such as education. Do each and every one of you have something that you teach or that you know, a product or service where there's an education piece? That's a great way to get media magic. We also talk about community give back. Is there something that you do that you're giving back? Is there some sort of cause? As you can see here, this particular article is so funny. It looks so small on the screen, but that picture was a quarter page, just the picture in a big newspaper. And so in here, we're talking about how we help patrons save on green, you know? And so this was our give back. And the other piece is human interest stories. we've all heard of the movie Gandhi or Aaron Brockovich or Seabiscuit. It's like everybody, I don't know about you, but the movies that I purchase, a lot of them are those human interest stories. And I love hearing about individuals that had challenges and how they overcame them. And I know some of you met right now, maybe having a story where you've never shared before because you're like, oh, I don't know if I want to share what's in my closet. I have to tell you, some of those stories with a little bit of relanguaging can actually be so powerful and so magnetic for people to get to know you, like you, trust you, and I want to know more. I have to say one of my initial stories was, some of you may have heard this story before, but when I was 19, I was in a very severe car wreck and was rear-ended. It ended up being four car collision. And in the end, ended up having shoulder surgery, which left me paralyzed. So I went into the, you know, dealing with like 9 months of pain. When I went back in, was paralyzed. And when I came out, I feel like destiny totally stepped in. I ended up connecting with a Qigong master. And even though I couldn't move my arm, I'm like, what do you mean doing these ancient Chinese exercises? This is kind of crazy, but I had no more insurance, nothing else to lose. And after a couple of classes, was able to move my arm. After 2 months, you can see now I have full range of my arm without surgery. And so I became so excited about, oh my gosh, I got to share this. But what did this have to do with my business? It doesn't really have anything to do with my business, but by sharing that story where people, you know, I think the headline that we had was paralyzed woman heals with ancient Chinese exercise. That headline, when it got picked up, it was like people started going, who is this chick? What did she do? I mean, it becomes that ripple effect of letting people know and want to know more about who you are. So, I'm gonna switch screens here because I want you to hear this video. This video is very powerful. I know some of you have seen this before, and some of you guys, when you watch this, you're like, I still tear up every time I see it. You're a little bit like me. So let me get screen share, make sure we're all set up, because this is really sets the stage of what we're here to do and learn. So
what did you do to my sign?
I wrote the same, but in different words.
Thanks, love.
Can we say cha-ching? I know I just went to a very emotional moment to like, oh my goodness, this is okay, escape. Let's get going here. This is the power of words. This is the gifts that we have. This is the ability. It was like just those few tweaks with what he was saying made all of the difference. So let's dive in now and talk about crafting that perfect pitch and what are the essentials that you need to do that. I'm gonna go ahead and drop these in at the end, but I want you to just, you know, we'll go through this and then we have the practice at the end. So the first thing is to know your audience. You really wanna know, who are you speaking to? Is it, you know, business owners? Are they salespeople? Are they investors? Like what is your audience? Are they parents? I also do events and event strategies. And I would tell people when you're working in an exhibit booth, and if you're trying to talk to something in business and they don't have a business, you're wasting your time. So it's good to know your audience, but it's good to also have some key questions up front when you're connecting with somebody, those engaging questions to get to know, is this somebody that might be, you know, in your, somebody to talk to. And I love starting with engaging questions because then it gets people to connect and say yes and get to know them. So number one is know your audience. Number two is know the opportunities. Is this a mastermind meal? Are you speaking for a minute? Is it one-on-one? Like there are so many opportunities to give a pitch. And the more you know about what is that opportunity, then the more that you can customize it and clarify it and make sure that you can get the desired outcome at the end, which leads to number three is know your intention. What is your pitch for? Is it client acquisition? Are you trying to get feedback on something? Are you doing R&D, research and development? Are you trying to get strategic partners? You know, it's very important to know your intention. When I work with investors to raise capital to develop their pitch, we often talk about in their pitches, like we want to be doing two things at the same time. We want to plant the seed that you're looking for investors, and we want to look at customer acquisition, right? If they're already in that wheelhouse. Diane, I know that you're, you know, you work with helping people build their business, but you're also looking for customers. So when you're developing your pitch, obviously you want to focus the emphasis on what aligns with your audience, what aligns with the opportunity. But if there's a way to get both of those in there, even if it's just planting a seed, that's really powerful. So getting clear on your intention. Number four, and this is where a lot of people struggle and why I love working with people, but it's being quick, clear, and concise. Quick, clear, and concise. When we are passionate about what we're doing, this can actually be one of our detriments. Now, people want to see and feel your passion. That is a magnet. That's important. If you're just monotone, you know, I really like to help people get media and I can do a good job. I can get you hundreds of things. It's like this. They want to know that you have passion. They want to feel that energy. But if I go on and on and on and on and on, more especially at an event, more than allotted time, there can be consequences. First off, people check out. Second off, you know, if the event presenter may not have you back, like there's a lot of consequences. So I always invite people to really either work with an expert or work with your language to be quick, clear, and concise. Number five, keep it simple. Keep it very, very simple. You want to imagine that you're talking to a fifth grader, right? Like you don't want to use acronyms or words that people don't understand, because what happens is if they have to try to figure out what things mean, for me, oftentimes I'll think, oh, I guess I don't fit or I don't understand. So it's not for me, right? Like you don't want people to check out based upon what you're saying. You want to keep it very, very, very simple and have it at a level that's clear. Number six, write it down. And that right there, out of all of these, is what I've seen is the biggest difference for people. I love telling the story about a dear friend I have here locally who is brilliant at marketing, brilliant at direct mail. This guy, we know direct mail has been very powerful. He has a tool of using direct mail and online marketing to where people get notices ahead of time. And it's like this whole buyer's journey with direct mail. And for the longest time, he was really struggling getting clients. And I got to know him over time because he was part of our community and that. But I'd see him at networking events and he would just struggle. And sometimes people were like, what the heck is he doing? I had him write it down. It took us less than 15 minutes to rework it. He went to the next networking event and it was like turning on a faucet for him. So that writing it down helps you get really clear on your audience, your keywords. Is it quick, clear, and concise? And what we love about the Business Acceleration Network is that you get to show up and we don't care if you read, right? Like this is your practice ground. This is your practice, you know, practice makes what is it? Practice makes perfect, or practice makes progress. That's what Dr. Bob says. Practice makes progress. And so we really encourage you, like, write it down. If you have not written down your elevator pitch, please, you know, take that one thing down today and do that. And we have different pitches, right? Depending on who you are. If you're a solo entrepreneur, I'm going to talk to you differently than I would talk to a corporation, right? If you're a startup, I'm going to talk differently than somebody that's already in revenue and expanding. So you really, you know, you may have many different pitches. When we develop people's expert power bios, we have various different bios that we work with. We create the long one, but then we look at that short one that's there. And number seven is be creative. Like, I love, you know, asking questions, quote stats with that third party stats. I love using the example of real estate sales. I just want to check my time here. You know, I my dad was a broker, my grandpa was a broker, and you know, obviously got into real estate, and I'd go to networking events. Oh, I'm looking for listings, I'm looking for buyers, I've been in Brevard, I've got, like, all of those things that we all do. How many of you have been to a networking event with a realtor and they say the same thing? Or is it just yes? How many of you are real? Is there any realtors here? Oh, okay, darn, because I love helping realtors with this. I love helping all you guys. But so what I learned when I figured this, you know, cracked this code, is I would literally go to a networking event, and this is really important, before you go to do your pitch, figure out what you can bring. You guys saw me in the beginning with my book. I was like, hold it right here next to my head. Hey, if you don't have the Media Magic Book, go to MediaMagicBook.com. Like, when we have something that we can show people while we're speaking, it can be really powerful. Don't leave it up the whole time, put it down. So what I would do for real estate, and this is just an example of being creative, I would go into the room, I'd stand up. How many of you, I'd say, when is the best time to buy something? People look at me like, what? And I go, come on, guys, you know, with high energy, when is the best time to buy something? And they just don't look at, I go, when it's on sale, right? And they'd start laughing. I go, real estate's on sale right now. Whether you're a first-time home buyer looking to tap into the $15,000 grant, do you hear how I said a number? And do you hear how I said grant? Free money? Like you, this is how powerful we can be with our elevator pitch. Or you're an investor that's looking for a good deal, and I'd hold up three MLS listings, then you want to come talk to me after this event and check out these properties. There's some good ones here. That's it. I wouldn't say my name. I wouldn't say my company name. I wouldn't say any of that, because that doesn't really matter to them, right? I have to tell you, 100% of the time, I always had somebody come up to me and talk to me about, what do you have? Let me see what's going on. And it was really, really powerful. And so that's the power of your pitch, coming up with stats, coming up with questions. And so let me go ahead and put this in the chat so you guys can capture this at the end here. So any questions about this part so far? No. Okay. Are we excited? Do we get thumbs up? Some good stuff. Okay. So when you're looking at this, like, when we go into Media Magic, we talk about a lot of things. Obviously, you know, we talk about what to do now. Like, if people are coming up with you, what's the process? What's the funnel? Anytime you do a pitch, it's important to, as I said in the beginning, if you have an opt-in, if there's something that you give away, if there's a gift, if there's a, you know, a meet with you, whatever that is, you want to include that in your pitch. Those are things that are going to, you know, maybe it could be the one little thing that draws people in a little bit more to what you're doing. I love, you know, I often tell people, hey, you want to learn about Media Magic? You want to get booked on radio for free? Go to radioguestlist.com. And there's hundreds of ways to get plugged in right now to get booked for free on podcasts and radios. So those are a few things. Let me get back to my PowerPoint. I just want to make sure I got all my notes. I do have to say, if you're sponsoring or speaking at events, or you're doing elevator pitches, I find, especially in our environment, now I'm telling you guys all this, and we kind of, if I'm in a circle or I'm in a group, I love to be able to go last. right? When we do our mastermind meals and things like that, because what that allows me to do is that allows me to get to know, oh, Carol, Carol's a doula. She needs help with this. Oh, Jessica, Jessica's a marketing expert. You know, like then if I can go last strategically, then I can see where can I best help people? Maybe there's something I can share or not share. So when we get in this, in the group in a moment, I'm going to give you guys some more examples. In a moment of for your own pitch, when we get in the group, I'm going to say, you know, somebody with the longest hair goes first or somebody with the shortest hair goes first. So we don't have to worry about that piece. But I find that that there's certain things that you can learn from the event. And if it's a first time I go to events, I often ask them, hey, what's my time frame? What do I need to know? When I talked about number two, know the opportunity, the more specifics you can get, the more you can show up and really nail it in the park and have a win-win. So let me pull this back up. Anybody have questions on their pitch? Anybody? Oh, come on.
I have a question, Shannon, real quick.
Yes, ma'am.
Just real briefly, I was taught to, when you're elevator pitch, to be extremely specific. And when you're saying, you know the opportunity, you know the audience. What if it's more of a general thing? I mean, is having, well, you're going to go through it, but I mean, how specific do we get for our audience? Like I generally say women over 30. Is that too specific? I mean,
So that's such a great question, Diane. And there, you do need to be prepared if you don't know your audience, right? And that's where that gift and those opt-ins can be really powerful. And Diane, if that is your ideal client, it is good to put that out there. Now, knowing the little bit that I know about you, I do know that you work with men and women. So depending on, you know, you've got to feel into that for yourself. If that makes sense. But obviously if you're in an audience, like we're part of the Women's Prosperity Network, you might say, hey, I love working with women over 30, right? Then that way it's there. But I kind of believe that, you know, that wide funnel and getting people in to see if they're a good fit. But some of you, like you're real clear. I've talked to people where like, I only work with people that have 25 more employees or more. If that's really it, then no. But if you do have that window where you work with more, Diane, then I would say open that funnel up a little bit depending on the audience.
Thank you.
Is that helpful?
Absolutely.
Perfect. Perfect. Okay. So here is an example of an elevator pitch that I have used many times. And I do not know why Zoom is doing this. I have never noticed this before, that gray bar. That's literally my toolbar. So it's very fascinating what's happening. So I apologize for this piece here. But you can see here where I have things underlined where I want to emphasize. And when you're giving your elevator pitch, if there's things that you want to stand out, then it's important to pause. It's important to have that place, you know, someone speaking about you has more impact than you, right? So it's like, use those variants in your voice and in your tone to really help people connect. Also, if there's successes that you've had, like in here, numbers and stats, you guys that have been a part of Media Magic, you know, where I say anytime you can drop in numbers, that's powerful. You know, to say that I've attracted over $3.2 million in free publicity, that number and that stat helps people go, oh, okay, this might be somebody to listen to. So even if you're just getting started, like Amanda, I am so grateful that you're one of our collaborators and I get to work with you. And this is one of the benefits of being a part of our communities. You show up and I'm going to highlight you, right? I can't help it. But Amanda has been in health and wellness and in, you know, healing and working with people for a long time in different ways. One from an office, you know, office manager in a medical practice. And like, this has been in her bones and in her DNA, even from her volunteer work for a long time. Now she's taking on a new endeavor with Theta Healing and many other things. That's just one, right? And so for her, even though it's that part is new, there's parts of Theta that she can say, you know, this is thousands of years old technology, right? Like you can use, if you're using other people's tools, you can bring that in. Now I did tell her like, hey, I wouldn't personally say that I do theta healing, because there's lots of people that do theta. We want to focus on you. We want the branding to be on you. You can say bits and pieces of what it does. It helps people break through prosperity blocks. It helps people break through health blocks, you know, see those blind spots. So we work with looking at making you stand out. But those are just some key things that if you're new at what you're doing, or maybe you're doing a new product line or things like that, you can leverage the experience of either the company or what might be there with the history of it. Hopefully that's helpful. So before we go into the breakout room, because I know some of you are going to be shy. And I do have to say, in Media Magic, we kind of have this rule of, you know, anytime you can get the mic, if I say, hey, Carol, do you want to speak? What's the answer, Carol? Carol, you're muted.
Ideally, it would be yes.
Yes. Okay, great. And so that's part of Media Magic, is anytime you have the opportunity to take the mic, it's like, yes, it's about being ready. It's about being willing. It's that, you know, you guys heard me in the beginning of this. I was kind of fumbling and bumbling and that. And it's like, you know, that's okay. People actually appreciate raw, authentic, not scripted things. I think I know I'm drawn to people that I can feel, hey, they're being real. And so there's a couple things that we have going on right now that I want to be able to share with you. That first is, we are doing a call right now for volunteers, sponsors, and mentors, even a few speakers, for our 8th Media Magic Sales and Marketing event. We have our 8th event. We've been doing this for quite some time. This is our signature event. I'm really getting a great lesson today in multitasking on Zoom with many screens. What makes this event so special is that this is not a lecture and learn. This is an event where we're working on your press kit. We spend 2 days, both beginning of each day, helping you craft that pitch. We get you in the room with mentors that help you with those various pieces. We help you with your expert power bio, because we know that power bio helps you become magnetic, where you can attract higher paying clients. You can get more yeses for contracts. You can get more speaking gigs, radio gigs. I mean, I have to tell you, when I cracked that bio code, that was just a game changer for me, because people, you know, it was like, it got to speak for me. I didn't necessarily like to, you know, brag about myself. So if you don't have your power bio, we actually help you develop that. And we help you craft a press release. And this is the free press release place where you can tie in and attract free publicity. Yang, would you be so willing to, I'm going to pull up the QR code in a minute, and then we bring in the media. So the media is where you get to ask them questions about, how do I get pitched? They're going to share their information on getting pitched. They're going to know that you just went through this couple day training, and they're looking for stories. And so this is a really powerful opportunity. If you are looking at, you know, creating your media kit, then we definitely would love to have you come. If you've been to our event before, you actually get $100 off. So we have an alumni program, because sometimes we were like, I didn't get my bio finished. I had such a hard time talking about myself that I need more help. Or maybe you're ready for your next press release, or maybe you did your personal bio. Now you want to work on your professional bio. So you can actually take a picture of the screen, be able to go directly to Media Magic Bootcamp and look at that. If you are interested in being a sponsor, a mentor, or a volunteer, Yang, will you drop in that event details for tomorrow? Because this, we have a rev share opportunity. We have a lot that we do, you know, within our community to be able to join, to join that. And so with that, I wanted to get you guys in the breakout room. So we have a unique opportunity in our community, because we are, okay, good. That's not there anymore. We like to help you grow your business. I don't want you to just come here and practice your pitch. I want you to truly meet people. And I know that when we come together with people, Carol, I don't know if you guys know this about Carol, but Carol knows people all around the world. if you're in the room with her, you are so lucky because she is another person with what I would call a billion-dollar Rolodex. This is an opportunity with this format. Now, we're going to share with you a little different format to share your pitch, because we want you to ask for what you need next. We want you to be able to say, hey, what I'm looking for, or who do you know? Those two end, when you end that in your pitch, for me, it gets that Rolodex brain of mine to go, oh, okay, you know, Carol's looking for doulas, or Carol's looking for moms that are pregnant, right? I can't help but go, who do I know? So when we do this, you're going to each get into a breakout room, and you'll be able to share, this is who you are, this is what you're doing, and this is what you're looking for next. And in that, you're going to get 3 minutes each. We're going to need a timekeeper. And so that timekeeper, and please, if you're not going to be here, please put in the chat real quick that I'm not going to participate, so I don't put you in a room. We're getting ready to do the breakout room, and I want to make sure that you're willing to play with us and be in the room. And so you'll share, and then the other two people, we're going to do 2 minutes of feedback. Now, with the feedback, and now it's real easy to get in the network. Hey, I know this person. We still want you, no, they're not going to be live streamed, George, because we only stay in this room, and it doesn't do that piece. Thank you. Good question. So in this, if you know somebody, like if I know somebody for Dave, I'm going to say, hey, Dave, please reach out to me. I want to introduce Rob Bartlett. Right? And I'm just going to give him a name, and I'm going to drop my contact information in there. This is a little bit like speed dating, that piece, but I'm going to do that name dropping so that he can connect with me after the fact. We really want you to be able to give that 2 minute of feedback, and it's going to be 1 minute each of, hey, I like this. I would change this. Please give positive what you like. Please tell them. And if you can end on that positive note, that's really powerful. Hey, you know, have you considered this? Or do you know a stat on that? Like, give them that feedback, but always, 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 you know, like we want to let people tell them what you love, tell them what worked. And so let me go ahead and get this created. Any questions about the breakout room?
No.
Okay, great. Anybody not participating? Young, I know you're not participating. okay, so it looks like we are going to be doing form. I'm going to sit down on this one. Thank you, Michael, for letting me know. I really appreciate that. Anybody else planning on sitting out so that I will make sure that we only have room with active people? Okay, perfect. So there is one room where you're going to have three people and the rest of you have four. It's going to go a little bit over. Hopefully you're able to stay with this until the end. Again, we want to be able to give them feedback, talk. If you can do 30 seconds, like you get 2 gold stars. That's like a win-win. No more than 60 seconds. Timekeeper, please say time. If you can give them a 10-second warning, 10 seconds left, and then you have to stop at that. This is where you get to practice, right? This is where you get to practice media magic, your Super Bowl commercial, very valuable. You've got to stop. Then from there, you're going to go ahead and get the feedback. And as the recipient of that, I want you to mute, okay? I don't want you to say, I want you to just receive, okay? Because we don't have much time. It's like, I like this. I didn't like this. You know, it's please mute it. Just receive. You can say thank you if you want more information at that point, but really it's just to be able to find those gems. There's going to be, it's like you're on the beach or in a mine. You're going to find rubies. You're going to find diamonds, and you're going to find a lot of sand. You don't need to explain. You don't need to justify. You don't need to take any of the advice if you don't want to, right? Like really, this is just for you to find those things that are going to work for you and go from there. So with that, when we get into the room, all right, looks like we had somebody else drop out. So Diane, I'm going to move you over here with one of my favorite people, George. You're all my favorite people, but you just don't know it yet. And I may not know you yet. All right. So it looks like we have three. This is perfect. Let me go ahead and readjust.
So how much time total do we have?
It's going to be 3 minutes total. 1 minute of pitch, Diane, and then 2 minutes of feedback. Okay.
Excellent. Thank you.
Okay. And so I'm going to, when you get in the room, you've got just like 30 seconds to pick a timekeeper. And then I'm going to say the person with the longest hair is going to go first. And I'm going to be just kind of popping in to see how you guys are doing. So with that, I'll show this slide in there again. You can skip your name. You can skip your company. You can say that if you choose. This is another format. You put those in the chat, but please try to end with who do you know that, or I'm looking for. Like, go ahead and just ask for what you want. This is the environment to do that. And the rooms should be open. Diane, go ahead.
Denise, I hope this is okay to share about you. She shared that she was brand new to this, and it didn't sound like it at all. You had all the confidence of a well-known veteran. So thanks for being so out there, Denise. You were excellent.
Thank you, Diane. I got to hear the beginning of it. And Denise, you're doing very sacred work. You know, it's like helping people at the end when we need that. I'd love to connect with you. We do a Love Your Neighbor. You know, if you go to thegreatestcommand.com, we do a Love Your Neighbor community. We work with family love letters. And I just think there could be, you know, it'd be great to have you in our referral network. So, oh my goodness. Thank you, Diane. Anybody else want to share it? Amanda?
Same thing with Arthur. This is his first media magic, you know, Shannon experience. And he stumbled through his elevator, and then we talked about it. He listened to mine, and he's rocking it. Now he just needs to write it down.
Awesome.
But I think to hear them is so poignant and gets it. Yeah.
That's wonderful. Well, and those of you that have been to Media Magic, I'm hoping you can hang out just for a couple minutes after this. I just wanted to powwow with you just for a moment. But you know, isn't it great to actually sit in the room with a mentor and get help and get guidance and get support to work on that? And just you being here, Arthur. So that you guys know, if you go to our Jan, can you post our next event? Next month that we're having that's free. When we do these events, we're doing the same thing. So we're going to invite you to come and get in the breakout room. We're going to continue to give out tickets, which I don't know if that's a bad sales tactic or a good sales tactic.
If it works, it's great.
Well, we'll see. We're hoping that you upgrade to VIP because that's really where the magic is. You get to bring a guest and all of that. But you get a chance here to meet other people. You get a chance to practice your pitch. You get a chance to get feedback. And so there's some really powerful things. So our next talk is going to be 13 steps on creating that expert power bio. And that is really what I feel like is the foundation, you know, next to the elevator pitch. People want to know who you are, and when they can hear who you are and what you're doing, it just makes it easier for them to say yes. And so that's going to be on September the 7th, 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I know Yong's going to drop that in just a moment. But we were trying to figure out, okay, how are we going to give away this general admission ticket? So first off, if you're not going to be available for November 10th and 11th, for MediaMagicBootcamp.com, please let us know, because we'd love somebody to be able to go or to be able to give to somebody. And so Yong, I'm going to text Yong right now a number between 1 and 25. And so what I would like each of you to do is in the chat, pick a number between 1 and 25, and Yong is going to tell us who is the closest. I've never done a Zoom contest, so hopefully this is a winner chicken dinner. So I've messaged Yong that number, and once everybody has it in, then he will announce the winner. All right. Going once. Okay. Claudine, I don't know if you want to get in. Michael, I don't know if you want to get in. Okay.
Can I do a plug for my experience so far while we're waiting for that to come in?
in just one moment. Is that okay? Because I do, we actually want to record a plug. That's what I was going to ask you guys, because we were looking for some testimonials and the end of Media Magic last time got cut off. So I would love to have that and hear that. Yeah. So we have, I don't know how to do this, Yang. Do you see what I see?
Yes.
Because what happened is Jessica picked the number first and Diane picked it after. So, like the double 11. I mean, that's a pretty good sign. What you guys.
So I have a runoff between the two of them.
That's okay, Shannon. I had planned on volunteering there anyway. So.
Okay.
That's fine.
Okay. Awesome. So our winner is Jessica. Yay. All right. Let's get the round of applause.
It froze.
Oh, Jessica, don't look so excited. I don't know if she's frozen.
Yeah.
She is. Frozen. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So Jessica, Yang is going to go ahead and share in the chat how to. That was so funny. I'm like, boy, she's really excited. If you guys could see the picture. So Yang, if you'll go ahead and share in the chat with her how to get registered. Jessica, we do encourage you to do the VIP or the elite. That's going to give you the general admission credit, but you can pick either one of them. And we're so excited because you're an alumni. So we know you're going to be back. So one more round of applause.
Okay.
And so with that, thank you guys so much for joining us. We hope to see you back on the 7th. Yang, I think you went ahead and to save the chat, if you click on the three dots next to where you type, you will find, you'll be able to save the chat, it'll pull in everything from your room. Also, here is the upcoming webinar. If you want to join us on our meeting tomorrow, if you're interested in volunteering, sponsoring, mentoring, that meeting tomorrow, here is the link. That link there is directly to sign into the Zoom. We're not registering, just show up. And we'll go through all of those details there. And so with that, I just want to remind you guys that there is thousands of dollars of media with your name on it right now, right? There's a faucet waiting to be turned on. And so, just knowing how to do that is that simple thing. I'd love to be on this journey to be able to help you do that. Hopefully you'll sign up now for the Media Magic Bootcamp. What happens is we have these regular webinars leading up to it. Once you sign up and you register, we're going to start working with you now. So like Jessica is enrolled. So when she signs up to these webinars, we're going to start working with Jessica, right? Because we're like, okay, we're prepping her for this event. She's going to get the homework right away to start working on those various pieces. Because again, as I said, this is not a lecture and learn. This is an event where we get stuff done. So with that, Carol, I'd love to hear your testimonial for the tape. We're going to go, okay, take one, Carol.
So for those of you who don't know, I don't have any background in how to do a press release or this arena. And I turned to Shannon to be my doula in this world to birthing the media. She did a fantastic job, and I forgot over 500 impressions across the world, actually. So I was thrilled, and I love the fact that there was a system and a nurturing support system that went with it. And she kept tabs on me when I got lost and redirected me. So very user-friendly. So I appreciate it. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you, Carol, so much. Anybody else want to share? Carol, I'm actually going to show your press release because you got more than impressions. You actually got picked up by over 550 outlets, including Asia One and Market Watch and AP News. And it was so much fun to tell your story. And one of the great things with our syndication service is now she has language that experts have written for her that she can put on her website, she can use in media swipes. I mean, like it's multi-purposed. It's really some neat things, because sometimes that language is challenging. Would you guys agree? It's like to talk about ourselves is a little bit challenging. Anybody else want to share their experience? Okay, Amanda, thank you.
So when I signed up for Media Magic, I thought, it's another one of those things, you know, but hey, I can just hit end. No, I cannot get enough of Shannon, her process, the whole support group of this family. The Media Magic family is incredible. They've taken me so far. I have a lot of things to do. I've not met all Carol's goals, but I'm well on my way, and Shannon keeps me focused, as well as just the whole group and the support. It's really amazing. And the value you get does not end when that marketing is over. The resources continue, you continue to grow, you can continue to build. And there are so many other resources available to refresh you and to help you along the way. It's just, it feels never ending, and it's awesome. Thank you, Shannon.
Thank you, Amanda. I love working with you. Anybody else want to share before we say farewell?
So I have a question.
Okay, George, I love your questions.
Well, thank you. So it's been a while. The Media Magic, is this all online, or do you have to drive to a location like you did before? How are you delivering this information? How are you delivering this workshop?
So that is a super duper duper question. We do it all virtually. We even, George, you've been to my events. We even do the breakout lunches. So the VIP, we bring in the mentors, we take a pause and we eat while we're here. And so it's all online. We have we've got pretty cool sound system here, so we can have our, I get to do DJ and everything all in once. And I have to say, George, the feedback that I got from people like you that have been to multiple events, they were like, this is the first Zoom event where I didn't want to fall asleep. Like they wanted to, most of the people were on their cameras and engaged. And so we do it all virtually, which keeps the cost down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I can't imagine you making anybody want to fall asleep, but that's thank you.
Thank you, George. All right. Well, with that, Jessica, I am just so, you have no idea how excited I am that you're coming to Media Magic. And she, at the very end, she has this incredible gift. George, you'll probably love, I hope it's okay I'm saying this, Jessica. She's great at marketing. She's got lots of really powerful tools in her toolbox. And she is an incredible healer. And at the end, we were in a room and she ended up doing this beautiful prayer and advocation. And it was just like people were feeling and connecting. And Amanda, were you there for that part, or Diane? Oh my gosh. It was like, I'm like, I don't know who this girl is, but she's got some power through that, those airwaves. So I'm really grateful that she's coming again.
And I just want to state, Dave is new to this community, and we had a nice time with him in the breakout room, and just want to welcome you to the community.
Thank you.
Thank you. I really enjoyed it.
Wonderful, Dave. I'm so glad that you're here. So with that, you guys can join at any time, the Trailblazers Club, collaborators. Yang, I don't know if you want to put that in there. It's like 27
code. 27 my phone.
All right, so I'm going to drop that in one more time if you want to be a part of our ongoing community. And with that, I hope, nope, that is the wrong one. That's Carol. Just remember to save your chat. And Dave, hopefully we'll see you back. Michael, author, Claudine, and if you want to join our community for ongoing basis, as I said, Amanda has acts. We come together to play together. So with that, I will see you soon. Oh, let's play some music. Let's have some, there we go. Thank you guys.
See you tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you, Shannon. I'm so excited, Diane. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Yang. Yep, our events. We put our event link in there if you want to see everything we have going on. Denise, come play with us. Bye for now. Yeah.